Hey guys, what is going on? It is Purdue here, and we are back with another Madden 21 Ultimate Team video. We got gameplay for you guys, and you see his top three there. He's got absolute goons in the secondary, Ronnie Lott, Pat Pete, and Deion Sanders. But we're coming out with the ball first. We're going to try and go triple option on this first play, and you guys are going to see this is how you execute a triple option. Somewhat. We just get that pitch out, but Barry's able to get enough space to get a great gain and make it big. And here we're trying to go with the pass, guys. We're going to try and go deep. He's running cover three. I'm trying to hit him with the beater here. And you're going to see we're going to try and look for Lynn Swan over the top here on the left side. If we can roll out, trying to set up the blocking. Not easy, though. Absolutely disgusting, man. You see, we toast him with Lynn Swan there. Absolutely love it. Lynn Swan is such an animal. You can't cover him, especially if you press him with 97 speed. You're not keeping up with Swanee. But here you go. He's coming up with his Gun Ace offset. And I have to say, this guy ran a really, really good offense I had not seen yet from Gun Ace. I've seen a lot of people come out and run a few plays from this formation, but I've never seen someone stick with it for a whole game and run their whole offense out of this one formation. It made me really understand how good this formation really is if you have the right abilities for it. And he was running two tight ends, both with tight end apprentice. I'd never seen that before either. He had Jermichael Finley and I believe it was Vernon Davis. It's Jermichael Finley and it was Darren Waller as his tight ends. And they were absolutely disgusting with the speed and the tight end apprentice. It was really hard to keep up with them. And a really good offense, I gotta say. Here you see, we blow up the trap call. And guys, you're gonna see a lot in this gameplay. It really is a Terrell Edmunds gameplay. But unfortunately, he's not gonna stick with the team anymore. You guys see, we get a lot of hit sticks with Terrell in this game. And he has 93 hit power. But we get no forced fumbles, man. I don't understand why. Fumbles don't happen this year. And the other thing, the reason really why we got rid of Terrell's card is he doesn't get Acrobat because he's not a 90 overall and he doesn't have a power up. He can't get there. So I like having Acrobat on both my possible users. So I switch back to Taylor Mays. So we're going to have Taylor Mays still out there with Troy Polamalu. So no matter who I user, I will have Acrobat. And I can just get that much better animations to get more user picks, guys. Because it really does make a difference. We're all feel I'm right there with Terrell. And if I had Acrobat, it's an interception, but I just can't. And there you see, we absolutely whiff on a tackle. I should have gone for a regular tackle and not tried to hit stick him there, but I was out of position on the trap play anyways. But either way, he's having a really good drive. We're almost at the end of the first quarter. And again, still in this ace offset. I don't believe he came out in a different formation the whole game. Here again, going for trap call, and there we were ready for it, and we blow it up with Terrell. Again, in the backfield against a tiny Raheem Mostert. And you guys see, 93 hit power still just doesn't do anything. It won't blow anyone up. But like, fumbles are just such a fluke, man, that I honestly don't even recommend getting hit power this year. I think, like, the only reason you should hit stick is to try and stop reach forward animations on the goal line, because reach forwards happen so often now, but you really shouldn't even have to. Like, I think just go for tackles more often, and I know I always go for hit sticks, so I expect fumbles, but looking at more now, I think I should just go for regular tackles more often to try and secure the small yardage gains, because you're not going to force fumbles, and the only reason you're going to hit stick is if you're trying to stop a reach forward on the first down. So if they're right at the edge for the first down or the goal line, then I'd say do a hit stick. But there you see, we really get a really good, nice, that's bad language, bad English, but a really nice stop and go with Saquon Barkley. Absolutely lethal. We're able to stop, read the gap, and get upfield. And there's the QB wrap with Michael Vick. Another great game there. So we come to a 3rd-and-1, trying to figure out what you want to do here. And we're going to go with a read option play, I believe. Yeah, we're just going to read the slot corner on the right side. As you guys see, and he's crashing in. So we get a free release with Michael Vick. And we're taking off. And Jesus, Vick just trips over his Taylor Mays. But here we go again, guys. He's giving us this cover three look. So we want to hit it again. We want to do it again, guys. We're going to go deep. Oh, boy. Lynn Swan, here we go, bud. You guys ready for this? Okay, guys, I don't know. You can tell me. I thought that was open. His Deion Sanders came and made a great play on the ball, but I really thought that was open, so that really annoyed me. But I've noticed a lot of times, too, on cover three beaters, I find now that since I got rid of Vic's roaming deadeye, he seems to underthrow them a lot when he's on the run. And not even that they're not accurate. They're accurate, but they're just underthrown. So I'm going to go back to the roaming deadeye and see if that really makes a difference, because especially I love rolling out of the pocket and throwing now. I'm doing that a lot more with the tight end apprentice. So I'm thinking we should really try and keep roaming deadeye on. So to make up for the one ability, I took off the Polar Elite on Brandon Sheriff, our right guard. And we're just going to have Polar Elite and post up on our left guard, which is John Hanna, but still we're keeping post up on both our guards and our center. So the offense is still looking really good, but I think being able to have roaming Deadeye in the passing game is going to make a big difference. But here you guys see 46 seconds left right before half. This guy's driving, man. Like I said, he has a good offense, and he's just dotting us up. Troy Polamalu's right there, but just can't make a play on the ball, even with Acrobat. Whoo, but Mink is making one there for us. That's where Acrobat and Flat Zone KO is so beautiful. Because we're always playing zone coverage, the Flat Zone KO makes up for it there. And I've noticed Minka will get some nice animations in coverage where he'll get breakups, where if he doesn't get a layout like that, he'll come jar it loose and he gets a good animation. So I think for us, the Flat Zone KOs are really good abilities. And there's different adjustments I want to make in a bit of time, guys. Like, I'm thinking about changing up a few of our Steelers players. I'm thinking I'm honestly may... There you see the great interception. But I'm thinking I may honestly want to try and get Shaquille Griffin somewhere on the field, because he's such a great zone coverage corner. I really want to see him out there. And I think we may have to get rid of Rod Woodson or Mike Hilton, but we'll figure it out. But either way, you guys see we got horrible blocking there. Able to come around though on the read option, and our guys make up for it there. We get absolutely incredible blocking. Ebron picks up the beautiful block on the outside corner. And again, this nickel 3-3-5, we are able to run against it right now because there are no read keys for us. We're just going to go with a trap play here, and we are just moving the ball effectively, guys. We are moving it at will. And unfortunately, that was it before half. We were just trying to get a few yards, see if we could pop something loose. And that's really it. Like I tell you guys, we want to see if we can get Vic runs. I tried one there. We weren't able to get it. So I just want to see if we could pop one with Barry. And we actually almost did. It was very close. But here we are, 7-7 at half. And guys, this is a tight game. This is an absolute defensive battle. This guy is moving. But Terrell's got his X factor. So anything that comes near us, we should be able to intercept. Able to get him under pressure there and able to have the ball thrown away. 2nd and 10, we gotta do the same thing here. Only gonna send 3, trying to mix up coverages. I'm really trying to play everything because he's got the little angle up from his running back, and horrible user by me. That was just absolutely disgusting. I didn't cover the post route because the trouble is he'll throw to the running back sometimes on that little Texas route, the angle route, even like you see there, even when TJ's in coverage there. So I get worried about that. It's so annoying. I have it manned up on the cross pattern with TJ and it still just won't get covered. And there you guys see again, we get another hit stick to blow this guy up in the backfield when I don't think his running back was expecting it, and still can't find ourselves with any animation, except we get one there. Ooh, baby. Terrell Edmonds able to get us another interception on the user. I think that's 3 we've had today. Like I said, Terrell Edmonds is an absolute monster, guys. Like, if you guys are running a Steelers same team, I seriously think if you want him, get him. I just need to have Acrobat on my user. That's my big thing. I really find Acrobat is a necessity. But here you guys see we have the ball. We're driving. 1 minute left in the 3rd quarter. We're just looking to kill clock. And if we can do it effectively, we may be able to end the game with a walk-off field goal. Here we're going back to the triple option. And what the hell is that? What was that pitch animation, guys? You tell me. Barry, like, took it and received it in such a weird way. Like, I've gone pitch animations where they take it and keep going. But he, like, went back 7 yards when he caught it. And it was so weird, I don't know. But 4th and 6, we go with the read option because we're ballsy with Michael Vick. We are a run first team, guys. If there is no read key, I promise you, I promise you, I promise you, we will run a read option. If there is a 3-down line set, 4th and 20, I promise you, I promise you, we will go with an 0-1 trap because I believe in the blocking. I believe in our ball carriers. But most importantly, I believe in my stick in the open field. I believe that if I get a little bit of room, 18 inches of space, like Gale Sayer says, I will make the miss. And I love it. So seriously, guys, I hope you guys enjoy this gameplay. We are still fighting. 3rd and 7. We go, we fight, we find the delay fade to Eric Ebron outside of the pocket, and he reaches for it, and he gets us the first down. We're still driving, guys. Down 2 minutes and 30 seconds left. We're trying to chew this clock out, see if we can get a game-winning field goal. About to take it to the 2-minute warning. We're still moving. And we're just short of the first down with Barry Sanders. And here again, you guys see there's no read key. 3rd and 2, trying to make it look like we're going to pass. But like I said, if there's no read key, we want to take these free shots with Vic. And here we go. We're taking the read option. And boom, he slides down. And there you go. Vic is down 1st and 10. And we're able to take it to the backside. Nothing there on the run. 1:26 left in the game. We're still fighting. We're in the gun wing. And we're trying to see what we're doing. We motion the tight end over, seeing if we can get our guy to motion offside. He doesn't. So we're just going to look to go with the read option as it is drawn up. And we're just going to give it off to Barry Sanders up the middle. Only able to get a couple of yards, not very much there. Now we're down in the 3rd and 11. And I'm looking, guys. I'm trying to block. I'm blocking 7. I have the delay fade. And I throw this way too early. If I would have waited, Lynn Swan would have burned from deep. And the curl flat wouldn't have played that. but I threw it way too early. I thought I was under pressure and I tried to get rid of it sooner, and I was impatient, guys. I threw that way too early, and that was just horrible on me. So we got to try and step up and play defense, because like I said, you guys see the scoreboard. A field goal will win this game. 48 seconds left. He is down, and Terrell Edmonds with the user steps up again, and we get another interception. Terrell is a god, man, especially with the X factor. Anything that comes near him, he will pick off. And that is enough for that, guys. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Have a happy Thanksgiving. Please like and subscribe below, and I'll see you boys next time.